Thank you. Alive, I always feared the cold embrace of death, leaving this world like a man sinking into the depths of the ocean, becoming one with the seabed, turning to silt. My embrace of religion was that of a child, huddled beside a nightlight. When you killed me, you showed me a purpose, a state of being never truly believed could exist. Why don't you come out and join us? How great it would be to thank you in person. Well, even if that term, in person, might not apply to you.
Thank you.
How bold of you to presume safety in that tomb of glass and steel of yours. Under these pressures, rivets waver, supports buckle, and glass cracks. How long do you think you have left? I, like you, had a family, dead before me. I have been promised I can see them again, and I believe those promises more than the empty words of a free world. You should think about them. You've noticed the presence. I can see it on you. Haven't you always wanted to be part of something greater? It was why you joined the company in the first place. I think you'll soon be very pleased. The depths call. Won't you listen?
It doesn't Just the four of us for days upon days, not a word from the surface, not a ray of sunshine. Just the depths and the dark and the dank. And if that weren't bad enough, then you go and decide to blow us all out into open water for the pressure of 200 atmospheres bearing down on us. Our deaths were instant, but you bet your sorry ass they weren't painless. Now I know, and you know, that this isn't new to you. You already knew all this. But I'm going to let you in on a little secret. That guilt that you've been pretending like you don't have? The paralytic, mind-numbing horror of what you've done? All those logs you spent all that time writing? Well, that's all been according to plan. Our new friend's got all the details he needs on you. Now all you two have to do is meet. I'm sure you'll get along swimmingly.
Thank you.